everybody. I'm also a resident here in Mount Vernon and a part of Citizen Artists. There's a mayoral forum for citizen artists, which are people in the arts and culture here in Baltimore, where they're looking at all the assets that the arts bring to all of our communities and asking the mayor specific questions about what they think as far as careers, jobs in the arts, and also bringing a vision for Baltimore through the arts to the outside world of the nation. And so that's going to be held at MICA Monday, March 7th, 6 o'clock. It is a 90-minute forum, and we have stuck to 90 minutes every time. We've had 6 listening sessions throughout the city, and we welcome you all to join us Monday, March 7th, 6 to 7:30. We have invited every candidate, but we are not taking each candidate's own actual speeches in the beginning. We are asking them 5 questions that we gleaned from 5 different communities throughout Baltimore, and then we are also asking the community to continue to ask more questions. So it's all about your questions and then we speak.
All right, the first candidate that's going to speak now is from the Green Party, Mr. Joshua Harris.
Throughout history, it has been the inaction of those that could have acted, the indifference of those who should have known better, and silence of the voice of justice when it mattered most that has made it possible for evil to triumph. I'm here tonight to ask you to take action, to no longer be indifferent, and to never ever remain silent again. In Baltimore City, for far too long, we've had leadership that has refused to take action. And they remain indifferent, and we continuously see it over and over again. My name is Joshua Harris, and I believe that the single greatest issue in Baltimore politics is the distribution of capital, or the lack thereof. Yes. For the last 4 decades, mayors have chosen to only allocate capital to certain parts of Baltimore City, those that touch downtown and the harbor, while the rest of our neighborhoods have been left to fend for themselves and scrape and fight for every grand dollar that they could to try to organize and make it better themselves because they were neglected. As such, my administration will focus on creating healthy and economically viable neighborhoods. We want to bring Baltimore City into the 21st century, creating jobs, 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 jobs. My goal is to bring industry back to Baltimore, using clean energy and energy efficiency to create jobs in a city that has more than 40,000 vacant properties and hundreds of miles worth of infrastructure that needs to be redone and should be done using energy efficient technologies. I'm also the youth guy. I have a passion for youth like no other. A rec center saved my life. I clearly have a little bit of hype. And if it wasn't for rec centers being funded and open, who knows where I would be at today. For the last 2 administrations, at least, we've continuously cut funding for education and for our young people. I was raised by a single mother, and so that left me a lot of opportunity to spend time with my grandmother, who used to take me, my older brother, and my younger sister to these events where people wore green shirts all the time, and they would sometimes protest and yell, and then other times they would meet and plan, and sometimes they would just celebrate together like a family. It wasn't until I was older that I realized that my grandmother worked for the union fighting for workers' rights, because she believed, just like she taught me to believe, that every single person deserves a living wage job. Every single one of us deserves the opportunity to one day know what it feels like to become a homeowner. And every single one of us deserves equal opportunity and access to provide our children with a quality public education. And so, of course, I believe that that comes down to opportunity and access. And for far too long in Baltimore City, we've had elected leadership who have neglected to provide opportunity and access to the other Baltimore, which is where I live at, West Baltimore. We sit here in beautiful Mount Vernon, which has reaped the benefits of being so close to downtown and the harbor, but where I live at, it's not the same. And so I know that together, if we want to, and if we elect leadership that is transparent, accountable, and responsible, we can create jobs in Baltimore City. We can provide quality public education for each and every one of our children. There's no reason that our schools should be without heat on 20-degree days. And together, we can create a Baltimore that is truly for all of us, despite what your zip code or what neighborhood you happen to have been born in. Again, my name is John Ferrari, and I look forward to your questions. Any questions? No questions?
No questions.
Good evening, Josh.
Yes, sir.
My question is, as an individual that's running for mayor, and hopefully and prayerfully will end up being mayor, how do you feel about the cities, the mayor and city council not having control of the Baltimore City schools?
It's a huge problem. So one of the initiatives that I'd like to see is at least a minimum of partially elected school board, because we have to have control of our schools and the funding. Although, I will put this with a caveat, that right now what little control we've had, we have mismanaged. Cannot have $60 million disappear from your Department of Education budget. Find $6 million under the table and then expect the government and the state to give you more money. So we have to make sure that we're responsible with the leadership of the allotment to give us as well. But absolutely, we need to take control of our schools, and we have to understand that Baltimore City is unique. We have to make sure that people are here in Baltimore City elected and controlling our schools, who are invested and value the future of our children. So right now, one of the things that I'm looking at is actually PACE legislation, which is properly assessed, clean energy, that would allow for the reduction in solar costs, for homeowners who are interested in moving in the solar direction. But we also have to recognize that though solar may be more expensive up front, in the long term, we save more money, we reduce our carbon footprint, and we simultaneously create jobs for thousands of people right now in the city that need jobs and are ready to be trained for those jobs. Absolutely. That's a great question. So yes, I would. One, we need to train our youth and prepare them for those jobs and those careers that are coming down the pipeline. And any community that has a demand and is being excluded from having their voice heard, I would definitely advocate on behalf of them. Just as I'm doing right now in West Baltimore, where our city and city council and three other candidates have sat up here previous to this, allowed $18 million to be given to a wealthy developer without a substantive community benefits agreement, while excluding the communities of color. So yes, I would definitely advocate with that community.
Baltimore City is known as a one-party town. I applaud you being an alternate party. Will you do anything to help grow the Green Party?
Absolutely. And one of the reasons and one of the factors in me making this decision was that there are certain core values that are near to my heart, and I would always like to be at the forefront of any decision that I make. One of those, of course, being social justice, and then grassroots democracy. For far too long, we've had gatekeepers in the political machine that has controlled the narrative of our politics in Baltimore City. We've only been presented with one party, and so it is time for us to stop with the party affiliations and look at the issues and whose substance are we looking to address those issues. And I found that the Green Party is absolutely willing and ready to do that. And of course, we are looking to grow the Green Party and move our city forward.